Thank you, Faisal. It gives me pleasure to start the session by heartily welcoming everybody. I heartily welcome our resource person, Dr. J. Kristinal, Reader and Head, Department of Biochemistry, Rajas Dental College and Hospital, Tirunelveli District. I also welcome our staffs and my fellow students. Welcome you all. Without any further ado, I hand over the session to Dr. J. Kristinal.
So, excuse me. Okay. It's my bounden duty to introduce and welcome the resource person of the day, Dr. Kristinal. A short introduction and welcome. Okay. Respected Professor Dr. J. Kristinal, the speaker of today's endowment lecture, our secretary, Dr. Sister Geraldine Jayam, our principal, Dr. Sister Anne Purpert Sophie, our vice principal, Dr. Sister Lima Rose, our controller of examination, Dr. Vinolia Josephine Mary, our head of the department, Dr. F. Briska Renuka, respected colleagues, dear non-teaching staff, my dear students, and all participants. A warm good morning and a hearty welcome to you all for this endowment lecture on Research Modelers, Animals, Not Humans, and Academic Expertise. Academic Expertise Sharing Program based on the MOU with Rajas Medical Institutions. It's my proud privilege and honor to introduce and welcome today's resource person, Dr. J. Kristinal, Reader and Head, Department of Biochemistry, Rajas Dental College and Hospital, Kaval Kinnaru, Tirunelveli. She is a biochemist, completed her PhD in biochemistry from the University of Madras, Chennai, MPhil biochemistry from Bharathidasan University, Trichinopoly, MSc biochemistry, Srimadi Indira Gandhi College of Arts and Science, Trichy, India, BSc biochemistry from JJ College of Arts and Science, Pudukkottai, India. And she has also completed certificate courses in laboratory technicians courses, medical laboratory technology from Sri Venkateshwara College, Pudukkottai, Trichy. After qualifying herself, she served at various institutions in various capacities, like quality manager and head, Redo Labs, Chennai, lab manager and head, Medway Hospitals, Chennai, NEET trainer in biology at Nivedita Academy, part-time lecturer at Akkar Institute of Paramedical Sciences, Trichy, guest lecturer at Bharathi Women's College, Chennai, head biochemist at Trichy Diabetes Center, senior technician at Abhar Clinical Laboratory, Trichy. At present, she is working as the head and reader of the Department of Biochemistry, Rajas Dental College, and handling both theory and practical classes. She had rich experience in research, organized many conferences and seminars, published many research articles in reputed journals. Her contributions revealed her as a biochemist, a neurologist, a pharmacotoxicologist. She is the recipient of UGC BSR Fellowship Award from the University of Madras, June 2014 to May 2015, and also Dr. Lalita Kameshwaran Best Scientific Paper Award in a conference held at Tagore Dental College and Hospital, Chennai. She is technically sound in animal handling, especially rats and zebrafish. Techniques in molecular biology such as RNA, DNA isolation, polymerase chain reaction. Biochemical techniques like protein isolation, electrophoretic techniques, Western blot, ELISA, and enzyme assays, chromatography, both HPLC and TLC, hematological techniques, clinical pathological techniques, parasitological analysis, behavioral science studies, and in vitro cell culture techniques. She is a member of Board of Studies for Biochemistry in JJ College of Arts and Science affiliated to Bharathidasan University. Also, she is a co-guide for MSc Biotechnology and Zoology students from Bishop Heber College, Trichy, India. She is resourceful and delivered number of lectures like Alzheimer's and periodontal diseases, okay, ulcers in gastric mucosa, mercury, a health hazard, nutrition and oral health, zebrafish, researcher front, etc. Indeed, we are fortunate enough to have such an eminent resource person, and I'm sure that this program will definitely give insight on research animal models. On behalf of our department, our college management, I extend a warm welcome, dear ma'am. I feel privileged to extend my warm welcome to Dr. S. Anthony Selvi, alumna well-wisher of our college and department, and thanking her for establishing a MOU with us and for referring today's speaker. On behalf of everyone gathered here, I welcome you, dear. I take this opportunity to welcome all our department teachers and Dr. Jilt Arachi for their generous, thoughtful contribution, which enabled us to arrange such kind of activities. Hearty welcome, dear teachers. And on behalf of the Department of Zoology, I welcome you all, the management, the members of the Crossian family, my fellow faculty, scholars, students, non-teaching staff, and all the outside participants. Welcome one and all. Now, the session is given to hand over to the resource person, Dr. J. Christina. Madam, please.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
A very good morning to all. Myself, Dr. Christina. I'm going to share some of the points regarding that research modelers, and the topic is animal, not humans. Why I selected this topic means, usually models, humans are called as models, but here our real and exact models are animals for human researchers. So animal with the, I'm starting with this quote, that animal research and testing has a played a part in almost every medical breakthrough of the last century. It has saved hundreds of millions of lives worldwide. So before going for that animal models, we must know about why research is needed now. So a few of that points, it clearly explained about that. What is the needed for research? We have to develop a new knowledge because of that research, and we will know about how to prevent illness. And then another question, why people get ill? So, and these points are very important to study for that research. And we have to take some decision based upon that research for that best treatment. Why we choose animal models for research means they are very similarly human in all biological natures. In fact, mice, the rodents are share more than 98% of the DNA with us. and it's are most susceptible to many of same health problems like cancer, diabetes, heart disease, etc. And these models help ensure the effectiveness and safety of the new treatments. And one important thing that legally all drugs have to be tested on that animals for safety before they can used for the human. So usually laboratory animals can be classified into rodents, non-rodents and miscellaneous. Rodents like mice, rat, guinea pigs and hamster, etc. And non-rodents like rabbit, dog, cat, monkeys, and miscellaneous like zebrafish, frog, and pigeons. Now we'll see few of the animal models and important animals for animal models nowadays we are using for the research purpose. First one is the rodent, as mice and rats. Coming to mice, it belongs to family Rodentia, and they are the omnivorous. And its size is very small and easy to handle, and usually its size about 12 centimeter long. Mice are commonly as a Swiss albino strains. And what are the benefits of that mice in that research? Means it shares some anatomical, physiological and genetic features like us human, and 80% of the human genes are exactly same as mice, and rest of the things are very similar to the human. And another benefit is a cost effective, and because of small size is easy to handle for the research purpose. And one of the important thing, most of the genes are exactly same, we can easily manipulate, then we can add any kind of gene or remove it. Simply is called as a mutation. We can easy to do some mutation things in that mice. And it's have a short gestational period. Usually mice gestational period is 19 to 21 days. And it can be easy to produce more amount of the animals to handle. And it's a due to the short lifespan, that is 1.5 to 2.5 years, it's a fast aging process also makes that great effective to study that models for aging study. And these are the research highlights, and they can be used, mice can be used from genetics to virology, oncological studies. Similar that reproductive and nervous systems to human, they can suffer from disease such as cancer, diabetes and even anxiety like as a human. So it will be used to study for this following diseases. And it is to study of the complex biological system like atherosclerosis, hypertension, cancer, diabetes and neurodegenerative diseases. Even though if that mice cannot immunodeficient, it can be useful for that cancer and AIDS research. But recently also mice have been instrumentally used for that produce COVID vaccine. And next animal modeler are rat. So the rat is the second most cited animal models used in biomedical science. After that human mice, rat is the third most animal used in that research purpose. Compared to mice, rats are bigger and generally more aggressive and more resistant to various ailments. These rats usually albino rats, and this have two most frequently models are Sprague-Dawley and Wister's. So Wister rats, we'll see about that difference between the Wister rats. First, Wister rats encompass of number of rats substrain that can be derived from that past 15 years before. That Wister rat strain mostly it's an outbreed type of Wister Han and Wister U, that is Wister Unilever, and Wister Cato and Wister Firth are the inbred strains. It is one of the distinct honor of being the first rat stock developed to serve as a model animal. These are smaller body size than do Sprague-Dawley rats, offering potential for easy handling. And Sprague Valley rats, they can used as an outbreed rat in the biomedical research. It has an excellent reproductive performance, which is an ideal model for generating time-pregnant females. And its docile nature, easy to handle compared to the Wister rats. The typical longer tail which present in the Sprague Valley rats compared to the Wister rats. You see that the body structure is different from the Sprague Valley rats. We can identify that Sprague Valley rats with this that face nature. Usually compared to that Wister rats, in that Sprague Valley rats, it's look like a very chubby, and that body is little bit bigger than that Wister rats. And for research highlights, it can be used for to study of analgesic and anticonvulsant studies and behavior like lactation studies, hepatotoxic studies, and biopsies of various hormones such as insulin, oxytocin, and vasopressin. And rats are better in that removing toxin from their bodies. So we can be easily use of that toxicity studies. Most of the metal toxics and most of the toxic chemicals we can use in that rats due to this removing toxin easily compared to that other animals. And next one is rabbit. It's belong to that family Aporidae, and they are a herbivorous, and they are medium sized animals that can be grow to that 50 centimeter, and it cages weight about 4.5 kgs. And its gestational period for rabbit is about 32-33 days, and lifespan is about 5 to 6 years. Although rabbits are not commonly used in research, there are some beneficial natures which present in the rabbits can be used for the research. It's very docile animal and easy to handle. It's non-aggressive, so easy to handle for the research purpose. And it has a short life process, including gestational, puberty, and lactation. From this nature, it can be useful for that studies of reproduction, aging, and development, amongst others. And research highlights of that rabbit in that for the dosing purpose. Rabbits were the first models for studying atherosclerosis. We can easily study that atherosclerosis in that rabbit compared to that and other animals, because it's a high sensitivity to a high cholesterol diet, which makes them useful and easy model to study that atherosclerosis research. The enzyme which present in rabbit atropine esterase, liver and plasma, it can tolerate large dose of atrophin. So it can be used for that atrophin studies. And studies including that cancer, glaucoma, eye and ear infection, skin condition, diabetes, and emphysema. Mostly it can be useful for that study of eye and ear infections. They are another thing they can useful for that antibody research and productions. Nowadays that recent researchers also used for that antibody productions for that COVID disease caused by SARS-CoV virus. Next, that our modelers are the guinea pigs. So guinea pigs are the guinea pigs are Hello. Sorry. Guinea pigs or domestic guinea pigs, also known as that cavy or domestic cavy. It's a herbivorous, eat greens, fruits, and seeds. It's highly sensitive to that histamine, and the biological experiment on domestic guinea pigs has been carried out since 17th century, and it's also a beautiful model to find out the tuberculosis disease. And it was used as 17th century, and after that only we can use that another rodents such as mice and rats replaced by another rodents. In research, it can be primarily as model to study such a medical condition as juvenile diabetes. And another important study is tuberculosis, scurvy. Why the scurvy? Research in that particular guinea pigs means, like us humans, they can't able to synthesize the vitamin they require from the diet. So that easily considered model as for that scurvy studies. And pregnancy complications in humans. So that their placental structure is similar of that humans, and the gestational period can be divided into trimester and resembles the stage of fetal development. So these characters easy to study the, about the reproductive system and the gestational period for the fetal development studies. The German scientist Robert Koch used guinea pigs to discover that TB was caused by the bacterium Mycobacterium tuberculosis in 1882. It was a great honor in that guinea pigs which used. And as I told earlier, that vitamin C was discovered through research on guinea pigs 1907, since vitamin C can't able to synthesized by that guinea pigs like as a humans. It contains the serum enzyme asparaginase, which shows an anti-leukemic action. So it can be useful for that antibody production against that leukemic condition. And another excuse me. Another model is well-known zebra fish. So zebra fish is a Dinorhoea chain, is a freshwater fish belonging to the family Minnow. It's commonly found in the non-saline areas of lowland, standing. And the pH between possesses a long intestine with large absorption area. It's very small in size and easily maintained. So it can be easily used for that research purpose. The use of zebrafish as a model organism was pioneered at the University of Urgino by 1917. Zebrafish can grow up to 6.4 centimeter in length and is seldom grown in 4 centimeter in captivity. It has a lifespan of 3.5 years and can live up to 5 years above. They exhibit a gradual aging process. So more than that, aging studies can be easily useful for that neurobehavioral studies. And most of the important thing is it can share 80% of the genes which associated with that human disease. As a vertebrate, the zebrafish has the same major organs and tissues as human, like as muscles, blood, kidney, and eyes, share many features with that human system. And zebrafish are not more useful model for the human disease that mainly takes place in the tissue type body part that zebrafish do not have, like prostate, mammary gland, and lungs. So apart from that, other studies can be performed by the zebrafish. So most compared to adult zebrafish, we can easily use that embryo for that research studies. So zebra fish produce hundreds of offspring at weekly intervals. It grows an extremely fast rate, developing as much in a day human embryos development in 1 month. So they are easily transparent, and we can't able to see, and we can't able to induce that toxins or some other chemicals for that research purpose easily. So eggs are once fertilized and develop outside the mother's body, and it's an ideal model organism for study early development. So every blood vessels in that living zebrafish embryo can be using as a jar for low power microscope. we can able to easily induce that thing, chemicals and whatever that toxins, anything, it can be used to that microscope. And it's easily fast development embryo. So we can use so much of studies for study purpose for that human embryo, zebrafish embryo. So in that zebrafish, you have female and male zebrafish. It can be identified based upon their body structure. So usually, female zebrafish has a round body shape, and that in that stripe, it has a silver pigmentation. And in male zebrafish, its body looks like a fusiform body. And in that stripes, we have orange pigmentation. So for 5 reasons, it's considered as a zebrafish. Even that stripes and look like a zebra, that stripes look like a zebra. And that stripes from starting from that head and its extend to up to fins. So in the zebrafish is used to study for that neurobehavioral, because of its social animals look like a human social behavior. It's easily useful for that neurobehavioral studies, and that it, blood counts easily compare with that human cells. It's related to that structure, and hepatological studies also useful for that zebrafish. So finally, we can use research animals, research laboratory animals for models for human identified disease. So we can nowadays that animal research can be a very tough to without ethical clearance. We can use that animals without an ethical clearance. So this is the one of the thing we can't able to use that surplus of the animals for the research purpose. So to help the minimize and harm the animals, we can use alternate things like 3 R's: replace, reduce, and refine. So we can replacing that animal study by using that cell cultures and computer modelings, or human volunteers by in vitro instead of that animals, and reduce the number of animals by using improving experimental techniques. So if we got surplus of the animals per groups, we can use the 10 animals, 20 animals. So we can reduce that animals for the further. So it's being that pill. The leaf states it that pets third one is find the way that and else cat that stress or pain pets states that's with this sorry for that interruptions. So as I told that replacement and reduce that number of animals using and refining the things, we can save animals for that further purpose. So thank you. once again for that being patient.
That was very interesting. Thank you, ma'am. Now it's time to clarify your queries. If any, please switch on your mic and ask me.
Any doubt? A lovely and warm good morning to the secretary, principal, vice principal, and Mrs. Jelt, controller of examination, and our valued and worthy resource person. Dear colleagues and beloved students, it is a matter of pride for me that I am proposing a vote of thanks for this meeting. I, on behalf of my colleagues and the entire community of our college, first of all, spread my most sincere thanks to the Lord God. I want to thank our management giving this opportunity to us. I want to thank the research person who gave her vital time for among these. Her busy schedule to grace this meeting. We have the same topic for the second MSc students in the endocrinology. It is very useful, ma'am. So far, we have done only a very few little part. We have taken very little part. Actually, there is no books to refer this part, but this is very useful. How the different kind of animals, different species of animals, in what kind of work it is used for. It is very useful for that. Further, a big thanks to master of the meeting, that is Mrs. Matilda Boy, assistant professor of Department of Zoology, and the members of dental department from Rajas Institute, for having efforts towards today's event. I would like to place my hearty thanks to all the student participators because of whom we made this meeting possible. I also want to thank my friends for their cooperation to conduct such an informative session. I can't give thanks to everyone for their participation and mobility to take on the accomplishment of this meeting work. I show appreciation to the people who have been strength of this meeting. Once again, I would like to state that we are glad to all here over the meeting. We thank you for being with us. It has remained a pronounced pleasure. Have a great day ahead. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Ms. Christina for
the wonderful
talk. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Shall we wind up?